ScoopOnScoop is sponsored by
Metropolitan International University. Get a bachelor's in information technology and computer science, arts and science in education, international relations and diplomatic studies. To apply, please purchase application forms from the university or download from our website. Registration is now in progress at our main campus in Kisoro with branches in Bara, Kampala and Mitiana. Metropolitan International University, empowerment through knowledge creation.
A lot did go down this weekend. This weekend was, it was kind of sad. We lost someone who pretty much contributed a lot to the industry. That's, of course, Dennis Rackler. And then we also had some weird other things. Now, you see, when the sad things are happening, the happy things are happening, the weird things are happening, and shade is still being thrown. Now, my shadiest moment of this weekend was when certain side minister who used to own a certain side school, actually Kampala parents, why am I even joking? I'm not trying to hide it. And he was like, back in my day, when this and this, this and this happened, he did it. Basically, he was just trying to insinuate that when he ran the school, the students were getting the same grades that were up to par. And now that he is not running the school, he is not there. According to him, they're not doing anything, but I have my take on this. So we shall definitely delve into that. But before that, my name is Tina. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. It's a fresh new week. January is officially coming to a close to all those thirsty guys. And when I say thirsty guys, they have not been able to go to bars. Anytime from now. Okay, on a sad note though, Dennis Rackler passed away in an accident. I think that was on Friday night, and it was quite a shocker, you know. I met Dennis Rackler, I think, in 2013. He's always a jolly guy, not that much jolly, but yeah, for some reason, his soul definitely, may he rest in peace. But then it got me thinking about so many things. After Dennis Rackler had passed, then I took to, you know, everyone on social media was like, my goodness, RIP Dennis Rackler, RIP Dennis Rackler. And I'm like, what? Even the celebrities are coming out. I see Morris Curious say something, Winnie Nwaje say something, Zizo Bafana say something. Everybody decided to say something. But in my heart, I'm asking, on a regular day, when Dennis Rackler was still alive, how many of you would have been caught in the same space with him? I ask myself, apart from music, what relation does Morris Kiria and Dennis Rackler have? You see, I have a problem when people are just being two-faced because he's part of the industry and you're supposed to convey your condolences, but it's not really heartfelt because you're like, I never knew the guy, but you know, I just have to say something. Yes, we all have to say something, but it just made me question. Half of y'all you're alive, you're walking about and around. But ask yourselves, when you do pass on, who are those two faces that are going to come walking by? But because it was sad, it was just sad. I could see these people who barely did even know the guy, but they're all pouring out their condolences. And I'm like, saying you're sorry and you know, RIP is not bad, but did you really mean it? And besides that, I know they don't speak ill of the dead, but half of these artists who are saying something about Dennis Rackler wouldn't be caught thinking about his music. Half of y'all don't even know his songs. All the songs that you knew were Tugenda Kusula Munga, To Kabite with Desire Luzinda, and that was pretty much it. Oh, and maybe Dunia. Does anyone else know anything? So for all you celebrities and artists who are walking around and calling yourself celebrity, at some point in life, I'd love for you to sit back and reevaluate. How do you want to be remembered when you're gone? And do you want to be that relevant for the right reasons? I had to give it up to Dennis Rackler. He did his time. He definitely gave his heart and soul to the industry. It never lapped him back quite because he never quite took off, you know, he never shot up, but he did his thing. So for that, may he rest in peace, and it's a good thing he added a lot to this industry. I always get so psyched when I have to talk about Desire Luzinda because everyone knows it's gonna be juicy. Now, like I said, this weekend had ups, downs, rolls, turns, twists, and there were so many turns. Now, the most recent turn was when Desire Luzinda took to all her social media pages and she was pissed. She was literally at the verge of crying. Anyway, this is how she was like. She was like, I can't believe some media houses, you took to your papers and your blogs and you said my daughter had failed her PLE. First of all, my daughter got 11, but just because I didn't come out and tell people doesn't mean that she failed her exams. You people are wrong. If you have beef with me, my beef with the media house is entirely our beef. Don't put it on Michelle. And I'm like, Are you done, Desire? Now my turn. Desire, first of all, it's so wrong that anybody would portray that about your daughter. It's really, really wrong, given the fact that, you know, she gave her all and she did her exams. It don't matter. Secondly, Desire, why do you care what the world thinks your daughter got if you know what it is that she scored in her PLE? Like, Chimenyani. Like, even if we sat here and we said she failed with flying colors, she failed. To get that taller fizzy. Are we going to come and look after her? Are we going to come and spunk her to life? Are we going to even mind what she'll do with the rest of her life if she's failed PLE now? I'm just asking. And then again, Desire, I ask myself. So, you're complaining that we're talking about Michelle, who is your daughter. And then you forget, once upon a time, we never used to talk about Michelle. We just knew Desire had a daughter. She's pretty, she's somewhere there, and we respected that. You officially brought her out to us. You brought your daughter out to the paparazzi, to the media, to the world. It was basically, she was a debutante. She came out and she was like, wow, bang, I'm here. And you expect us not to say nothing. I'm not saying it's right. It was wrong. I would also be pissed off as a mother, as a parent. But I'm just saying, there's certain actions that you know, for every action, there's an equal reaction. Now, you had your action. This is the reaction. Why are you complaining? I'm just saying. Here's the thing. At times, you don't need to clap back or clarify about anything because it shows the class that you have. Now, in a situation like that, all Desire had to do was not say, Jack, you are just going to walk on by, let whoever is saying what they're saying say it. And before you know it, a week has passed. We're still talking about PLE. Okay, with the exception of me talking about it now because of your situation. Who else cares? I'm just saying. Desire, you know that when it comes to the Ugandan music, to the Ugandan industry and the paparazzi, Desire, Luzinda and Positivity in the same statement don't get along. Why would you expect for us to reach out and give you positive? I mean, we always have to spin it with you. Not that it's a lie. At times it's the truth. Okay, most of the times it's the truth. No, let me clarify. It is the truth. So, Chuck and Deuces, we cool? Omlangila Suna was kicked out of his house? Wow! Okay, first of all, I'm not even laughing at this whole situation because the story came out, the photos fell out, and I was like, such is life. We all have our ups and downs. It could happen to any of us at any moment. But here's the thing that made me actually think and want to talk about this situation. You remember that time when I came here and I told celebrities, Bambi, please get a freaking day job. Now, I gave that advice to most of the struggling hip-hoppers, who we call rappers, and I gave that advice to people who pretty much know they can't sing but they're trying to hardline. So now, what have you been up to? I hear you drive a Corona. Couldn't you sell the Corona and pay rent? And at the end of the day, I'm tired of you celebrities trying to keep up appearances. So you're driving around town. For what? Why are you pretending? Why do you want to play pretend? Here's the thing. Go out, get yourself a day job. Even if you're a successful artist in Uganda, it is not a guarantee that someone is not going to come and knock you off your stool, you know? So get a day job. So at this particular point, I'm not laughing at Omlangida Suna. I'm just saying you should have seen this coming at some point. You know what I'm saying? Where are we ever going to run away from the fact that Salvador knows basket mouth now? I was just trying to find angles. Remember how every time Salvador has to remind us that he's friends with Basket Mouth? Now, there is a high probability that Basket Mouth, according to what's doing rounds in the stories and on his social media pages, he's saying he was knighted by the Queen of England. So at this particular point, he is going to be called the Sir Basket. I'm just saying. Now, whatever shall we do with Salvador? He's going to walk around telling us, my brother. My sir, he is officially knighted according to him. I've not yet clarified until England comes out and gives us a statement. If the royal house doesn't come and tell us, yes, Tina, I've not even asked me. If the royal house don't come out and tell me, yeah, boo, we did, they knighted him. You saw the photos, they were real. It wasn't a replica. Because, I mean, I watched Mr. Bean. There was that scene where they got a queen lookalike with the whole knighting and then, you know, I dab thee. It could be one of those state. It could actually be one of those movies. I don't know yet, but it is what it is. Anybody. can't say anybody can be knighted by the queen herself, but where are we going to go with Salvador? Muchebuze muko agendo muto kuba ku face. Bobby Sizer, it's been a beautiful Monday. I hope you had a blessed weekend, and I'm hoping you have the best of the week. My name is Tina. Don't forget, at TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. You can catch us on Facebook. That's the Scoop on Scoop Facebook page. Leave any comment, any question, any query that you have, we'll answer it. And for all of you on YouTube, if you feel you've watched or missed an episode, we upload them every day. So for your rewatch, for binge watching, you know where to find us. For now, though, it's been my time. I'm out. Peace.
ScoopOnScoop was sponsored by
Metropolitan International University. Get a bachelor's in information technology and computer science, arts and science in education, international relations, and diplomatic studies. To apply, please purchase application forms from the university or download from our website. Registration is now in progress at our main campus in Kisoro, with branches in Bara, Kampala, and Mitiana. Metropolitan International University, empowerment through knowledge creation.